All right, we are live on our first episode of what's going to be called Boots and Bantz. Well, really, Rich, we don't really have a name for this yet. We are going with Boots and Bantz for right now. Offered your suggestion, right?
That's correct, because we threw this together in, what, about a half an hour tonight?
Yeah, we decided to do something just a little bit different. So basically, we're going to try and bring you guys a weekly show, reactions to boot releases. For example, today we're going to be talking about the Adidas Crazylight boots that were released today, and anything else that pertains to the boot world that happened during the week. And yeah, it's going to be live for you guys to check out or on our YouTube channel. But yeah, we're still up in the air with that name, right?
That's correct.
So if you guys have any suggestions for a name of our show, hit us up in the links down below, or in the description down below. Let us know. Or else talk in the... I know we have a group chat going right now, so if anybody wants to give us their input in the group chat, feel free to give us your suggestions. And we might even give you a free poster. How about that? We use the name
free
that people come up with, right?
Free stuff. All you got to do is come up with a name.
All you got to do is come up with a name. And as I said, we're going to have this as a weekly show. It's going to be pretty quick and hard-hitting right from the beginning. And the first thing we're going to get into is the Crazylight. And I'm going to bring up an image of the Crazylight in just 1 second. Oh, here we go. Of technology, huh?
Yeah, that's a wonderful thing.
It is. This was a lot easier when I was testing it earlier. Oh, here we go.
Did you get it? Where'd it go?
I got it. Can you see that screen right now?
There you go. You're up.
All right. Took us a while. So these are Crazylight boots that were released today. Pretty extreme from Adidas. All about super lightweight releases on top of their current technology and current boots. We got, from left to right, we got the Nitro Charge. In center bottom, we got the Predator Instinct. Above that, we got the 11 Pro. And on the right, we've got the Adizero F50. And each one has its wild visual characteristics. I think the difference with these ones is the fact that they've dropped the weight on each release. The Nitro Charge is down to 7.9 ounces. Predator is 7.5. The 11 Pro is 6.3, which is incredibly light for a comfort style boot. And then the Adizero F50 is 4.9 ounces, Rich.
I could not wear that as nice as it looks because my feet would be crippled after about 5 minutes.
And I think my socks wear like weigh like 4.9 ounces.
I know it's
okay. Out of four, real quick, you got a favorite?
The one I can't wear because it's too light. It's just something about the design of it. It reminds me, and this is going back to my days as a history major, of like a World War II naval ship.
Got that kind of camouflage style going on.
Yeah, the dazzle pattern, so you don't know how far away it is.
Well, I'm a fan of the Nitro Charge. I kind of like that blue-green.
Yeah, but what's with...
Have you got a least favorite?
Yeah, and it's the 11 Pro for several reasons. The first is, if I'm not mistaken where I've read, it's gone to a synthetic upper.
Right.
And I'm not sure what to make of the orange snake, which is covering the boot there.
I'm the same. You know what? I am right there with you. The 11 Pro just for me doesn't work. That black, orange, wild, crazy pattern just doesn't work. What about you guys watching right now? Leave us a comment down below and let us know if there's a particular boot that you don't like and why. Pretty simple, right? Yeah. I'm interested to hear what other people have to say. The one thing I do like is the fact that the Predator now has a sprint frame sole plate.
That is nice. I mean, that means they've gone back to what the old LZ had as well. So.
Yeah, it's pretty unique, right?
So they'll have got it down. So yeah, because they what was the original Predator Instinct? 9?
The original numbering?
No. The actual weight on it, because they.
Oh yes, it was
the comfort.
It was closer to 10 ounces.
Okay, yeah. So they've dropped because they found.
I think it was 10 ounces.
So they found 2.5 ounces.
Mm-hmm. That's what you call it, super lightweight. Hey, real quick, your moment of the week. Give me your moment of the week.
My moment of the weekend comes from France's Ligue 1, or Ligue 1, between Olympique Marseille, when coach Marcelo Bielsa sat on a piping hot cup of coffee match.
I did see that.
I saw it this morning. I was having my tea, and I nearly spat tea out over the computer, just watching the Vine video replay and replay and replay.
Yeah, that's gotta burn just a little bit in the wrong places.
Exactly.
My top performance of the weekend. I've got top performance of the weekend. It goes to Southampton for 8-0 demolition of Sunderland. And you got to give it up to Ronald Koeman, man. He went into a tough situation. They sold so many players last season, and he brings in players like Pelé and Tadic, who nobody really heard of before.
And no, they're
just freaking outperforming everybody else in the EPL right now.
Southampton is doing now what the idea that Swansea had with Brendan Rodgers of bringing in players who nobody had heard of.
Yeah.
And of course, Brendan Rodgers went to Liverpool because that's what you do when you're halfway through a mission, is you leave and go on to a big club.
Yeah.
So, and Pochettino last year with the Southampton thing, now he's at Spurs. So, you know, next season, Koeman will be at, I don't know, Arsenal. I'm calling it now.
Manchester United. I don't know. Who do you take? Pelé or Lambert? Graziano Pelé or Ricky Lambert?
Well, in the Southampton system, they're both as useful. You take either one, but, I mean, you take Pelé just because he's younger and a little bit quicker.
Yeah, I think so, too. I think he's a better all-around player, if you ask me.
Well, you know,
yeah,
he's not the battering ram like Lambert is.
Yeah, that's true.
The classic center forward.
Let's bring up some boots that we currently have in test and review.
These
little ones, as you can see, they're pretty messed up and nice and muddy. They worked out pretty well. Actually,
yeah,
but a lot of brought something new.
Oh, it's a nice looking boot, but I'm also curious there, Brian. Seeing as you're out in the wonderful climates of California, home of artificial grass, how do you have so much mud on them? Because it never rains. All you get is sun and earthquakes.
That's true, but we're playing on a pretty muddy pitch on the Sunday mornings.
Sunday League
in Sacramento can't afford artificial surfaces. Can you believe that? It is California. Budget crisis right here. All right, so we got this is the one I'm testing out right now, which I posted a video for last week, or over the weekend, I think. Puma King 2? What do you think of
it? My opinions on that make me sound old, because the Puma King is the boot which Puma should not have touched whatsoever. Just leave it the way it is, like Adidas' Copa. If you're going to make a heritage boot sort of modernized, you go the same route as what Adidas did with the 11 Pro series. And it looks old, but, you know, it has some new stuff to it. So
yeah,
I do not like the King series at all now.
Definitely changed the King up, that's for sure. And the other boot I've got in testing right now is the Evo Speed, the leather version, which I haven't even taken these out or broken them in yet. I still have to get an unboxing video from them, so I'm falling behind in this one. But I like the leather in this, nice and soft.
Yeah, no, it looks looks really nice. And you saved me a question there, because I was about to ask you, early doors, how do they compare to the synthetic, which, as you said, was a step back from the 1.2.
I very much thought so, and that's why I'm kind of excited to test these out and see how the leather feels on them. So we got those coming in the works. And then for Rich, we got some boots for Rich.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, we got some boots for you, buddy, right here.
Ooh.
Fantastic colorway.
These
need to make their way into the mail to you, because I've kind of been sitting here for a week or two.
Yeah, no, they are a colorway which you're going to see me receive an absolute kicking in my Sunday league. Just absolute kicking.
Well, yeah. I'm going to enjoy reading about that, because you got to add that to your review.
Well, let's just hope that the weight on them being the lightweight Diodora release gives me that extra half step of pace.
You would hope so.
Just to avoid it. Just to avoid the 40-year-old guy in Sunday League who's just going to come in and try and take off my leg.
Can you get a photographer out there for that day when you're wearing them? That would be pretty
cool. I'll bring the photographer out because I'll team them up with my pink soccer socks that I occasionally wear when I'm going particularly garish.
I like it. You do that. All right, moving on. Let's keep it going here.
All right.
Next, we're going to talk about some players in the unusual boots that they've been wearing. And I think the first one was Paul Pogba, who's had his fair share of unusual boots recently. He's the guy that he wears what he wants, right?
That's right.
He was in the Magista, like a new colorway for the Magista Obra this weekend.
Did you get a picture of the new colorway? Or?
I did get a picture of that colorway. So let's see if I can use my Google Hangout magic. Pull it up. Oh, look at that. Hang on. Here we are. Here's Paul celebrating a little bit. As you can see, he's got those boots on.
Oh, they are. Oh, I was wrong about the colorway. They're just the they're the current ones.
Right.
Because that's the white black.
Well, not Paul with Paul the wears what he wants, man. And he does it in style. He's a good player. The other player that we were going to talk about real quick was Adnan Januzaj, who today, and let's see if I can again work my magic.
This will be good. Let's see.
Today, he was wearing, as we can see right here, some Warrior Superheats. So the kid is gone to Warrior.
That is a huge signing for Warrior whenever they formally announced that he signed with them.
I would imagine it has a lot to do with his Belgian buddy, Fellaini.
He's taking advice from a palm tree. I don't know how to feel about that, though.
Well, he scored a good goal today, so we'll give him that much. But as you can they're obviously a whiteout version, so he's still trying to hide the fact that he's making the transition over.
Because I believe he was wearing the Hypervenoms recently, was he not?
He was wearing Hypervenoms, you're right. So that's going to be an unusual switch if he does make the transition over. And speaking of Warrior, the rumor mill going around right now, is that they are going to switch over to New Balance completely, which would be pretty unusual for a brand to switch over like that.
No, it's really weird, and it's something that I'm not personally that big of a fan of. I mean, when I think New Balance, I think running shoes, which sort of haven't changed since the 80s in style. When you think Warrior, you think of the bold, aggressive stylings, terrible kit designs if you're a Liverpool fan, which I'm not, thankfully, because I wouldn't be able to spunk out money for those kits. But yeah, you think bold, aggressive styling, something new, something people haven't seen. And with New Balance, you just think reliable, nondescript.
Now, do you think there's a chance that they would change the kits over but leave the boots as is?
I hope they do. Do I think there's a chance? No. Everything is going to go New Balance. Warrior as a brand will just be entirely swallowed up and cease to kind of exist.
And that's what I'm thinking as well, because in the past week, we've seen a lot of Warrior boots go on Warrior boots go on sale. Their prices have substantially dropped, and it seems to be that the brand is trying to close out their boots.
That is a shame, but also great news for everybody who wants a deal on Warrior stuff or hasn't tried it.
Exactly.
Myself included.
Some good boots out there. But here's the thing as well. I would have said 2 or 3 years ago that I wouldn't have wore Under Armour boots, and I ended up wearing Under Armour boots and liking them. So maybe it will be a case of New Balance pushing and promoting their brand through a lot of marketing. And making it a success of the range. Who knows?
So the hope is Warrior as a brand continue making boots.
Yeah.
New Balance take over the kits, and they let the conservative people design decent-looking kits.
I'm with you on that one. All right, buddy. This has been a fun time.
It has. It's a learning experience for me, but, you know.
Yeah. Well, we'll keep rocking it. We're going to try and bring a weekly show for sure, and we'll also cover new releases. Anytime anything new comes out, we'll try and piece together a reaction video for it. Sound like a plan?
That sounds like a plan.
I'm looking forward to checking out some comments from some folks down below, letting us know if they have any suggestions for the name of the show.
Yes, remember, the name is a work in progress, because this was done a half an hour ago, thereabouts, the idea. So give us something better, and you will win the poster that Brian modeled earlier.
Check this thing out. Awesome. Hey, one last thing.
Modeling it again.
Guess what I got in the mail this week? I got a color dye kit. So I'm actually going to try and black out a pair of boots, which I've never done before, and everybody always asks for advice on that. So I'm going to test out this stuff and see if it actually works.
That is going to be exciting to see. I'm curious about the idea of blacking out boots. I wouldn't do it myself. I can't color between lines, so that's my bad idea. But I want to see how it turns out, because I've never seen one come off properly, unless they've been professionally done.
Well, we will see, my friend. We will see. All right, you guys, thanks for tuning in. Hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. Give us a thumbs up so we know you were here checking out this video. Until next time, I've been Brian. He's been Rich.
And I have.
All right, see you guys there.
Take care.